Εις το όνομα του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Άγιου Πνεύματος. Αμήν. Please be seated. Αγαπημένοι αδελφοί και αδελφές, εν Χριστώ, καλά Χριστούγεννα. Ο Κύριος γεννιέται σε μία σπηλαιά, περιεβάλλεται από τον Ιωσήφ, τη Μαρία, τους βόσκους, τους αγγέλους, ακόμη και τους μάγους. Το θαυμαστό αυτό γέγονος ξεπερνά τη φαντασία μας για αιώνες. Πώς μπορεί ο Θεός να γίνει άνθρωπος? Πώς ο αθάνατος Θεός γίνεται θνητός? Το απέραντο γίνεται μικροσκοπικό. Το μεγαλύτερο θαύμα στην ιστορία της ύπαρξης. Γι' αυτό τιμούμε και εξηνούμε την Παναγία με τόσο έπαινο και ευλαβία. Είναι αυτή που γέννησε τον Θεό, τον κοσμιστή του Θεού, με σάρκα και οστά. Στέκεται ψηλότερα από τους ουρανούς και είναι πιο απέραντη από το σύμπαν. Αυτή είναι η αιτία που η Παρθένος στολίζει την όμορφη εκκλησία μας εδώ. Κοιτώντας προς τα κάτω και με ξαπλωμένα χέρια μας καλεί στην αγκαλιά της. The Virgin standing above all, looking for her embrace. Η Παναγία δεν είναι μόναχα η μητέρα του Χριστού, αλλά και μητέρα όλων. She is all our mother. Αυτή που τον γέννησε μας υποδέχεται σαν τα παιδιά της, προστατεύοντας, ευλογώντας και παρηγορώντας όλους. Όταν είμαστε καταπιεσμένοι, μας προσφέρει παρηγορία και δύναμη. Όταν είμαστε συγκλονισμένοι, μας ελαφρύνει την ψυχή μας. Και όταν υποφέρουμε, μας απαλύνει τον πόνο μας. She knows our pain. Αυτή η γυναίκα γνώρισε τον πόνο πολύ πιο περισσότερο από κάθε άλλη μητέρα. Είδε τον ομορφό γιο της, παραδόθηκε στις αρχές, ξυλοκοπήθηκε, ταπεινώθηκε και τελικά σταυρώθηκε. How a mother can watch her son be handed over, humiliated, and finally crucified. We can only imagine her pain. Μπορούμε να φανταστούμε τα βάσανα που υπέφερε? Η Παναγιά μας δείχνει όχι μόνο πώς να γιορτάσουμε τη θαυματουργή γέννηση, αλλά και πώς να παρηγορηθούμε και να δείξουμε συμπόνια σε όλους τριγύρω μας. She shows us how to be compassionate, to love, and to care for all. Ήθε αυτή η περίοδος των Χριστουγέννων να μας φέρει την ίδια αγάπη και χαρά που ένιωσε η Παναγία όταν κράτησε τον νεογέννητο μωρό της, κρατώντας την αιώνια ζωή του κόσμου. In her arms, she held life forever. Χριστός γεννάται, δοξάσατε. Christ is born, let us glorify him. We stand at a momentous occasion, a day that has marked human history for ages, for generations. We have marveled at the wonder of the virgin birth, of God becoming man, of the infinite becoming finite. How a woman's body can contain the uncontainable. How the Virgin Mary saw her son grow and live, although watching also him die. Now, the moment that he was born, as we heard from the Gospels today, the shepherds were there, the angels were there, and the three magi, I tris magi, the magicians, the astronomers, the wise men from a distant land. And it says that these men, these kings, brought Jesus gifts of gold, of frankincense, and myrrh. Now, according to historic documents, gold, frankincense, and myrrh were the accustomed gifts to be brought to kings and God. And there is an account in the 3rd century BC of a king doing just that, bringing to a temple, to a foreign god, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And so, with these gifts, there's both historic significance, but also the church has ascribed spiritual significance. Why gold? Why frankincense? Why myrrh? As you prepared for church this evening, as you prepared yourself, as you traveled, as you brought your gifts, yourself, your families, your mind, your heart, your soul, you made that same journey as the Magi. Maybe not thousands of miles, maybe not carrying solid gold, but each one of us in this room takes the place of the wise man when we offer ourselves. They offered gold as a sign of kingship, the precious metal that has been precious to mankind forever. Gold has been sought and fought since the beginning. It is precious, it is beautiful, and it has many uses. Gold has the ability to keep its shape, its shine, its luster for thousands of years. When archaeologists dig up the ancient death masks of ancient cultures with a little polishing, they are the same today as they are those thousands of years ago that they were made. And so gold has this eternal kingly quality fit for the eternal King Jesus. They also brought frankincense, incense, a sap collected from a tree that can be burned with a beautiful fragrant smell. We say that Jesus is a king, a priest, and a prophet. And so it's only fitting that the incense they would burn in their temples as an offering to God is the same incense that they would offer the newborn King, Jesus Christ. Just as you smelled and you saw the smoke surrounding the altar, the smoke which signifies our rising prayers to heaven. And finally, the myron, the myrrh. Again, another derivative from a tree. A sap that when collected is both an antiseptic, was used as a medicine, but most especially was used in the death ritual in the embalming ritual. I'm going to read something to you from a song we all know. And this gives us a hint. Myrrh is mine, its bitter perfume breathes a life of gathering gloom, sorrowing, sighing, bleeding, dying, sealed in the stone cold tomb. This significance cannot be understated. That tied in with the joy of the miraculous birth was the knowledge that this king must die. That he who is born for the salvation of the world would face his own entombment, his own anointing, his preparation for burial. And so it is with this charmolipi, joyful, sweet sadness, that all of our commemorations of Christ entail, that as much joy as we have, as much happiness and love and cheer that the Christmas spirit brings, it brings with it that knowledge of our own mortality, of our own finiteness, and of our own end. And so, in this season, my brothers and sisters, in this Christmas season, let us offer our gifts. Let us open our treasure chests and offer our gold, our best that we have, the most that we can give. Who we are as people, we give that as the gold. Let us offer the incense of our prayers, of our thanksgiving, of constantly thanking and worshiping and glorifying every breath that we have. And finally, let us remember our own anointing. That with each moment, with each breath that we take, knowing it could be our last, that every second is sacred before God, and that living with this knowledge that what we have been given is a gift, it is something that can be taken any minute. And so by living in a way that we offer God our best, we thank Him for every second of every day, and we do so with the humble knowledge that He is the King. And may this Christmas season bless all of us. May our hearts, may our lives, may our loved ones be protected and graced and blessed with the joy of the newborn King. Amen. Christos genate, doxasate. Amen.